fractional number. Okay, so now, first of all, we have to know what is a fraction. A fraction. So now, here we have an example. So now, here we have a whole, this one is a piece of sheet. Yes, it means that is a sheet of paper. So now, this is one, this figure one. Figure two. So, and now, if you take figure one and now divide by in a figure two into two parts, means that, do you see here, the shapes of figure one is different to the shapes of figure two. So now, the figure one is what you call a whole, yes? Then, a figure two, it is divided by into two party, means that this one part, this shaded part, is what you call a fraction. Yes? Means that a fraction, the definition of a fraction, is defined as any part of a whole object or whole part is what you call a fraction. So then let's consider any expression. So P over Q means that, it means that P over Q is a fraction. So where P is called the numerator, while Q is what you call the denominator. So, means that a numerator, yes, a numerator is a required part of a whole, while the denominator is a total part of the whole. So now, here I have an example. This one is a sheet of paper. So now, if you divide this sheet of paper into two four parts, one, two, this one, part one, part two, part three, and part four. So now, if you select this one, this side, means that this side is what you call numerator, because it is one, this is two, this is three, this is four. Means that this one, if you select this one, and now you have to divide by four, means that you select one rectangle, or we select one piece among us, four pieces. Means that this one, 1/4, is what you call a fraction. Yes? Where one is what you call numerator, and four is the denominator. So now, you have different types of fraction. So now we have the types of fraction. So the first type is what you call proper fraction. So we have the types of fraction. The first type is the proper fraction. A proper fraction is where a numerator is less than the denominator. Is where a numerator is less than denominator. Okay, so now, if a numerator, yes, if the numerator of a fraction is less than the denominator, you conclude that you have a proper fraction. So now, example of proper fraction, so you have 2/3. Another example, 5/7. Another example, 7/10. and so on. This is the example of proper fraction. So now, the second types of fraction, you have the improper. Improper fraction. So about the improper fraction is where the numerator is greater than the denominator. So now, if the values of numerator is greater than the values of denominator, you conclude that a fraction is improper. So now, example of improper fraction. So, and now we have 7 over 2, you have 9 over 4, you have 11 over 5, you have 12 over 5, and so on. These all are examples of improper fraction. So now, remember that the numerator is a whole, or is a required part of a whole, while the denominator is a total part of a whole. Means that numerator here, 7 is a numerator, while 2 is denominator. Now we conclude that this one is what you call improper fraction. So now, after studying what you call a fraction, so now we have any theories where a fraction it can be applied. Means that a fraction it can be used in geography. In geography, we need a fraction because it is used to calculate the scales of map. Another theory is where a fraction can be used. A fraction can be used in a business where a person who used a fraction for calculating a selling commodities or a buying commodities. So now another field is where a fraction can be applied. Now you can apply a fraction in science. About science, it means that remember that the gaze it can be represented in terms of fraction. So and so on. It means that you can use a fraction in sharings where you are going to share anything. Means that we need a fraction. So now, thank you, students, for watching this video. If you like it, don't forget to click subscribe, like, share, and write comments. Bye.